One held a gift. Two hid ferocious creatures. It was the lady or the tiger. Many of the thieves were once merchants simply looking to make a living. Sand swept across the land, scraping against the stone of a monument built not from devotion, but blood and sweat. Atop it stood a Nyalaha, with the lost ruler Bushman waiting. Breaking the circle, prevent the summoning. A new challenger appeared. Even fortune is in Rhea's hands, was all Margaret knew. On the other side of this city of thieves was the final stretch to Anai Raha's halls. The manipulator of the disenfranchised, the leader of rats, with fingers sharp as daggers, and a soul lacking its humanity.
Thank you.
was, no one chooses the life of a thief. The crystal was calling the hero back. Through a path opened anew from the sacred city of Anai Raha, the spirit of wind and weather. Bergson felt a strange wariness as home beckoned. The chamber groaned and trembled, darkness replacing light. Above, the family waited to eat, comfort replacing vigilance. Replacing happiness. One body was taken, but two souls were in need of rescue. Energy to the sanctuary was cut off, rendered useless. Corruption's delegate performed more than a kidnapping here. Lifeless, the sanctuary a shell of its former glory. Somewhere out there, surrounded by the darkness, Mary and her unborn child lay in need. The Bergsons would find them. hungers and ravens. It seized the lesser creature and took it into itself. Move, the Guardian thought, for there was no time to waste.